installation, it will take time. That time it won't take much time, just 5 minutes only it will take. 5-10 minutes only it will install. But anyway, so we'll go into do it. Okay, so guys, first check your availability memory always. Okay, and already told yesterday, so better disable your startups and disable your services if no longer required. Okay, you know, my Oracle service, which is I told now, so I am running a Oracle kind of stuff. So this is Oracle. It is currently stopped. If I start it, it will take another 1 GB kind of stuff. Okay, it is stopped currently. So point is, you can see. First of all, download Windows Server 2019. Okay, so it is 2016 as per your syllabus. Already I shared these links. Okay, so already yesterday I shared these links. I will explain what is server kind of stuff. First we do installations. Okay, here it is. Type like this, you'll get this: try Windows Server 2019 Microsoft Evolution version. It is a 180 days evolution. If you want, you can download 2016 also, no problem. Windows Server 2016. Be careful what you are download. Okay, and there is versions and all kind of stuff is also there. You can see it is a 180 days evolution version. First thing. The second one. Guys, as per your syllabus, they've given a syllabus that is showing a 2016. But I'm using a 2019 because of Hyper-V's 2019 version and 16 like that. It is some part is there. Point is, 16 or 19, both are same. There is no much differences. Okay, maybe in a future wise, maybe 1 or 2 points will be added, but there is no difference between 2019 and 2016. Okay, next, this is the place where you will get it like this. This is the link. You'll get it. You have to choose ISO. Yesterday only I told choose ISO. Okay, ISO, continue. You have to fill this form. The form. The form. Okay, so then once you fill the form, it will ask for a download. Just download it. It is also around 5 GB. Okay, around 5 GB. I'm not talking about like a 4.8 4.6. I tell you higher number. So this is how to download. Again, I already told right yesterday, so you have to fill this form. Give some information here. Okay, so randomly, then go to continue. Okay. Here it is. Click on continue. Okay, then select language to download. So language is English. Installing language is English. Language is English. Then finally download. Okay, so once you are downloaded, then we have to do remaining things. So I have already downloaded video is there. Sorry, downloaded image is there. So where it is there, I think yesterday I canceled it. Okay, for downloading. Don't worry. In a Z drive, OS folder. So this is my image. So you can see this is the my operating system image. 17763. This is my image. Okay. If you want to rename it like this, also you can rename it. Okay. like a Windows server, renaming it also no problem. So this is my server image. Okay. Like this. Yeah. If you got a problem, then please tell me. I will upload into Google Drive. Okay. I'll upload that into my Google Drive. If you have any problem to do it. So where is my Google Drive? I have a very less space. No problem. I will delete Windows 10, guys. Is your Windows 10 is anyone required, still requirement is there or already downloaded? Screen not visible. Now can you able to see?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, also I will upload into my Google Drive. Same link only. Yesterday, I think yesterday or day before yesterday, I shared a link. Voice drive link, same link only. Okay. So guys, I'm asking again. So if you, this is not required, please tell me. It is around 5 GB. Okay, so once it is uploaded, also I will, if in case if it is not done, then I will upload it. Okay, so this is my okay link. I will share it later, so you can do it. Okay, so this is my image. Okay, I use this one. Next one is you have to create a virtual machine for Windows Server 2019 in VMware workstation. Again, where to create a virtual machine? Where to create a virtual machine? Okay. So I'm going to this PC. Okay, usually I'll create a virtual machines in the H drive, but H drive is a 46 GB free. Better to create a F drive, but I'm creating H drive only, right? So I'm creating H drive, of course, no problem, because it's actually it is 500 GB drive. Out of 500, 46 GB available. That's why it is showing red color. Right, you see 6 GB available, but still blue color, red color. Because of percentage, so more than 80% you utilize, it shows red in color. I choose H drive because of an already in H drive I have a virtual machine. So you can see B1722. This is the your virtual machine. I store my virtual machines in this location only. Of course, I am going to delete a new virtual machine. So this is the location where I want to store it. Okay. Next. My virtual machine name is B17WinS1. This is my virtual machine name. The VM name. Then VM location will be like this. Slash virtual machine name. Okay, this is important. Next, minimum requirements. When you are downloading, there I closed it, I think. There only we can able to find what are the minimum requirement. Of course, I will write CPU 1.4 gigahertz processor. So we are all having a more than that one. So almost like a 2.4, 2.6 gigahertz processor are there. No problem. So one CPU, 1 gigahertz processor, one core processor, it is required. RAM, 2 GB RAM. There is no 64-bit kind of stuff, guys. It is purely 64-bit. Okay, purely 64-bit. Windows Server 2008 R2, 2012 R2, 2016, 2019, 2022 are 64-bit OS only. So no 32-bit here. Hard disk, generally 32 GB is enough. Or you can say 20 GB is also, you can say 20 GB is also enough. Minimum 20 GB is required. Okay. So display 800 × 600, that is okay. So this is the minimum requirements, but again, all depends upon your available memory, guys. Always check the available memory. Okay. So if you are having a 8 GB laptop, put a 2 GB for virtual machine. Okay, if you are having a your laptop having a 4 GB, then put a 1 GB for virtual machine. Okay. These are the main important. Now I'm going to create a virtual machine. New virtual machine, we know already. Typical or custom? I'm going to typical only, but because it's very less options are there. Guys, can I continue?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Select last option. And it is a Microsoft Windows only. So go to Server 2019. Select Server 2019. Next, you have to put a name. What is my planning name? B17. Location. Already I plan a location in my H drive. Okay, so it depends upon which drive you have. So based on that, you have to create. Okay, so location is also done. Virtual machine name, location. Next, 60 GB, enough, no need to add anything. If you want, you can put a 160 GB also, no problem. I'm leaving like that, 60 GB only, so we are not having more data to store also. They're not there in our practicals. Okay, so no partitioning partition we do it, but a 10 GB, 20 GB partition only, so not much required. So at present, so 60 GB, leave it. Can we make in a same folder where we make in a virtual machine? Yes, but little bit difference is there. Look at here. This is the main folder, H drive. This is my virtual machine's storage folder. So it is already occupied with a 17.5 GB. Now balance is, this is my main folder. In this one, new folder will be created. So this is my Windows 10 and other one will be created here. That's why I created like this. Virtual machine, same WinS1. That is WinC1, this is WinS1. Okay, but main folder is same folder. So both are existing in a same folder. It is not compulsory, but important is make sure your drive must be bigger, like a 100 GB or 50 GB free space must be there. Okay, in that one only, if you create all virtual machines in single location, it is very easy to accessible, easy to maintain. 60 GB single file. Next, go to hardware, customize hardware. What I must say, 2 GB RAM is required. Check it, my availability memory. My available memory is more than 2 GB or not. Yes, more than 3 GB it is there. So almost like a 5.3. Processor showing to change it to 1.1. One processor is enough. Select this option for a virtualization, nested virtualization purpose. You have to select this one. 1.1, select this option. Next, SATA CD RAM. Use ISO image file. And where is my operating system? In my G drive OS folder, this is my operating system. Browse. So go to Z drive OS folder. So this is my operating system. I selected my operating system. Okay, next, network adapter. I'm putting VMnet 1. For our server, we don't require internet or a physical network connection. Okay, so VMnet 1, remember I use VMnet 1. Again, I'm telling memory 2 GB, processor 1.1, and this check mark. Operating system, use ISO image, browse, and find out where is your image. Mostly it is in downloads. Okay. Next is VMnet 1. Close it and finish. So your virtual machine is created. If you want to see, from here, see it is. So WinSC1, WinS1, under this folder. Okay, under this particular folder. These two folders are there. In that one, you can see the operating system. Okay, machine is ready, but edit virtual machine settings. Few more settings are there now, so make sure that memory is 2 GB, processor is 1.1, check mark. I use 60 GB. Guys, sometimes, like you use 60 GB, you realize I want more. You can expand it also. Click on expand. How much you want to expand, you can put it like this, like 200 GB or like that. Okay, I use 60 GB. For me, it is enough. Use ISO image file, VMnet 1. Okay, next, go to options, advance, UEFI. Make sure UEFI is selected. And go to VMware tools, time sync off, select this option. VMware tools, time sync off, select this option. Click OK. So what is the next one? So is adding a three lines. So I have a VM edit file. Go to VM edit file. I'm adding these three lines to my virtual machine. How to add? So go to click on the virtual machine, right click, open VM directory. Now you can see your virtual machine .vmx file here. If you cannot see what is a .vmx file, better select this option. So you can see this is the option. If you click it, then only you can see .vmx. Right click, open,
and with notepad.
Okay, because last time I already opened with notepad, it shows here. If it is not showing, choose other app and select notepad from this list. And scroll down. select in a bottom. Yeah. So make sure it is last one. See the cursor is blinking. Make sure cursor is there. Then paste Control V. And still it is gone wrong. No problem. So it is a statement. After this statement, it is done. So better you can just like this, enter. Now it is in a strike. Okay. So it is simple to install, but you need a 1 minute patience. Okay. Great. Guys, again, I'm telling, if you are unable to add these three lines, you got confused or you are doing for, this is second time you are doing. So you can easily do it, but still you are facing some issues or you are forget, no problem. Okay, if you forget to add this thing, no problem. Okay, so finally add three lines also done. So I created a virtual machine, add the three lines, 2 GB RAM, 60 GB hard disk. How much RAM I put it? CPU 11. And check virtualize VTX kind of stuff. Next RAM, I use 2 GB hard disk. I use 60 GB single disk. Okay, so network. VMnet 1 is already I explained, it is a host only, means no internet, no physical network access. Okay, so UEFI. Sync time. Like that, these are our options we have done. So I'll just go through video only, we can able to understand. Okay, just I am going to start the virtual machine. Before I am going to start virtual machine, look at my, I have a 5.3 available memory is there. Okay, so if I close some few things from here, so I will gain more space from it. Okay. Including if I close this tab, we'll get it. So more space, I have more than 4 GB there. So for installation purpose, guys, already I shut down my Windows 10, so I got more RAM. Just for installation purpose, for now, I increase my RAM to 4 GB. Okay, just I increase my RAM to 4 GB for faster installation. Later, I will reduce to 2 GB because I have to work with two virtual machines. What to do now? You guys don't tell, then I can do. If you got this blank screen, what to do? Alt, Control, Insert. Tell me what to do.
Press Enter.
So make sure click on screen and press Enter. Now it is showing loading files and Windows logo. Okay, very good. So when it is showing, press any key to boot from CD DVD.
English India.
Very good. English India. Next. Tell me fast.
Install now.
Normally desktop will take lot of time because like desktop having lot of settings. Okay. Now which option? You don't know. So now following, guys, last option. Select last option. Okay. select the last option here. So what is these options? I didn't give even any introduction, right? So usually I will tell all these things earlier, but lot of people think it is boring. That's why I stopped doing that one. Okay, so you have to select the last option. Select the last option only. Okay. Do not select any other options, only last option. Next. OIS selection is done. License agreement. Next. Next. Which one?
Custom.
Custom.
New. Apply.
Apply.
Okay.
Very good. It do part. So it's same as a Windows 10, guys. Nothing is different. Only OS selection.
Next.
Next. That's it. So it is install. After installation, already administrator is there. So normally our Windows 10, we have to create an account. But in a Windows Server, the built-in administrator is there. So just we have to give the password for a built-in administrator. That is admin@123. Okay, then you log in. So finally it completed. Only last one is we have to install VMware tools. So let it install. It will take 5 minutes. Okay, just relax 5 minutes or take a break for 5 minutes. Okay, so what I'm trying to do is shift F10, task MGR. This part is not compulsory, that's why I'm not telling anything. If you want to do this, changing priorities, okay, update speeds like this. Okay, some people call this one as a software overclocking, but it is not. Okay, there's no software overclocking, but it is like giving priority to a particular processor. People think it is speed up the process. It's going on 20%. So just relax for 5 minutes. Meanwhile, it will be restarts. That to 4 GB RAM, I used it. I'm muting for some time. Okay, it is installed and restarted also. Let me see. It is taking too much time. Okay. So yeah, I'm not muted. Guys, installation is done. Okay, so it is already administrator is there. Just you have to give admin@123password. That's it. No need to do anything, just a mistake. admin@123. Okay, do not forget your password. Better to use admin@123. Why it is? If you forget a password, I can't do anything. Okay, just finish. So we'll get a now. It's showing Alt Control Delete to unlock. But if you put Alt Control Delete, it goes for a physical machine. For VMware virtual machine, Alt Control Insert. If you have got a doubt, so there is some options also there here. Like this, send Alt Control Delete to virtual machine. Okay, so like this. Login. So first time login, it will take time, like another 2 minutes for a setting administrator. Unlike regular Windows operating system, guys, server is used for a server purpose only, not like playing games, different type of applications, or watching videos, web browsing. These are all we don't do with the server. It won't work also. There are a lot of headaches also there. Okay, server is for providing services. Server is used to provide a services. Okay, Windows normal desktop environment is used to different applications, browsers, video, internet, accessing services, okay, games. Okay, so these are the desktop, means client operating system or a desktop operating system works. Okay, so what is a desktop operating system? It is used for running in applications, watching a video, watching internet. Okay, different type of applications we can able to run. We access the services from the servers. That's. But server is another hand. Purpose of server is provide a services, not a desktop purpose. So this is called as server manager. Just close this window. This is called as server manager. So click on a local server. You can see like this. Computer name, work group, Defender, NIC teaming, Ethernet. Okay. So these are different things, you will get it. So Windows Server 2019 data center, your processor name, RAM, okay, total disk space, like this. Product is not active, it is a evolution version. Okay guys, this is a flag, notification, refresh, notification, manage to add roles and features. Tools to manage the installed tools kind of stuff. View, you can increase the viewpoint like this and decrease also. Help. This is about a basic server, but I closed it. I want to install a VMware tools. The screen is very smaller. Okay, for me it is small, means it is very small for you. How to install VMware tools? Go to VM, install VMware tools. Either you wait for a notification or go to Explorer, File Explorer. It is notification is came. You can go for it. Do some message. Is not visible. Now it is visible. So I went to VM, install VMware tools, open Explorer, this case is the VMware tools. So double click. Okay, by double click only the wizard is started. If wizard is still not started, if it is open like this, okay, so because it's a 64 bit install setup 64. Okay. Because we are in a VMware, we are doing like this. If you are in a, really you have a server or a desktop, is a computer is there, you are installing in a physical computer. After installation of OS, what to do? Install the required drivers. Install the required drivers. But do not connect internet to your servers if it is not required. Okay. Only when very importantly, we have to connect to internet for updating your Windows server, you can connect it, otherwise not required. Next. Complete.
Next.
Install. Let it install. Last time, after installation of VMware tools, I restarted my PC. Okay, after installation, I done yes, restart. But this time, I click no. I don't want to restart. I will shut down my virtual machine. I shut down the virtual machine, and I will change the RAM to 2 GB, because for installation purpose only I use 4 GB. If I use 2 GB, it will take another 5-10 minutes. Okay, that's why I used. Again, some message. Okay, completed, finish. As I said, if you want to restart, just click yes. You have to click yes for restart. But I am clicking no, so difference is there. I'm clicking no, and I'm going to shut down this one. So how to shut down? It is like a Windows 10 only. Simply go to start button, click on the power and shut down. But this time it will ask some why you want to shut down. You can tell some reason or just click on continue. So Windows 10 is completed. Now it is shut down. Now mine is 4 GB RAM. I want to reduce to 2 GB RAM. Completed. Okay, so after that one, you can start the virtual machine. You can use it. This is your Windows Server 2019 installation. Windows Server 2019 installation. Guys, got it? How to install a Windows Server 2019?
Yes, sir.
Very good. So what I'm going to do is I'll stop recording.